Good afternoon, class. I am very sorry that I will not be meeting you through our conference this afternoon. I really have to go to Davao City for a very special and personal reason. And so I just made this pre-recorded video of the lesson about conventional forms of poetry. So this will serve as your final discussion before your examination on Monday and Tuesday. I hope that you we'll be able to at least finish this discussion. This is just a very short discussion, and I really want you to listen very carefully as we do the discussion. I hope you're ready. Let's begin. Conventional forms of poetry. Yesterday, we were able to discuss about the term conventional, and we were able to understand that when you say conventional, that means basic types. So this time, we are going to talk about the basic forms of poetry. What are the different forms and type of poems that are inside the poetry in general? So we are going to talk about at least three. All right? So along with the discussions, I will be providing you a sample of poems for each of these conventional forms of poetry. We begin. The first conventional form of poetry that we are going to talk about is what we call the Tanaga. Tanaga is a poem composed of four lines with each line having seven syllables. Again, each line having seven syllables, and this is a one stanza poem having four lines. So, one, two, three, four lines with seven syllable per each line. So, 7, 14, 21, 28. This particular poem has 28 syllables all in all. And it follows a particular rhyme pattern which are given here. We have the AAAA or AABB or ABBA or ABAB rhyme pattern. You definitely understand that, I know. Generally, it is a Filipino version of Japan's haiku. That's haiku. Disregards the Y. I'm a valuable player, maybe. I was just thinking about Haikyuu, the valuable anime, while doing this PPT. Well, nevertheless, again, generally, Tanaga is a Filipino version of Japan's haiku. And Tanaga don't require a title. All right? Again, one stanza poem, four lines, with each line having seven syllables each. So Tanaga has 28 syllables all in all. I have here examples. One Filipino example and one English example. Let's have first the Filipino one. Sa lugar na payapa, doon tayo nagkita, bagamat nag-iisa, tayo ay naging isa. Let's count the number of syllables per line. First, there are how many lines in this particular poem? Four lines. Let's count the syllables in each line. Sa lugar na payapa, doon tayo nagkita, bagamat nag-iisa, tayo ay naging isa. Alright? So that's 7777. As we say, Tanaga is a Filipino version of Japan's haiku. So we definitely have our Filipino version of words that we put into a poem to make it a Tanaga, Filipino Tanaga. But we also have our English terms, no? Never did I ever think I will see you in a blink. Happy am I see you, trembling saying I love you. Maybe I was in love in making this. Well, nevertheless, so that's the example for the English Tanaga. All right? I hope you understood that. Next, we have what we call Dayona. Dayona is a pre-Hispanic rhyming poem of three lines with seven syllables in each line expressing a complete thought. Dayona follows no rhyme. Here are some examples. Nevertheless, no, just like how we understand Tanaga, Tanaga has four lines with each line having seven syllables. Dayona, on the other hand, only has three lines but still with seven syllables each. So there are at least how many syllables in a Dayona? 7, 14, 21 syllables in a Dayona. And it doesn't require a rhyme. It doesn't follow any specific rhyme pattern. But always bear in mind that Dayona as a poem has to express a thought, a feeling, an emotion, an understanding. All right? I have here examples as well. I have a Filipino example and an English example. I made this myself to tell you that you can also do it if I can do it. Nagising sa musika, natutulog kong diwa, ngayon ay lilipad na. So that's 777. Getch? Yeah, just like your ICT. English term. Up above, I saw it fly. To the sky, it flew so high. Very petite hummingbird. So that's 777. See the difference between Tanaga and Dayona? They differ in the number of lines in a stanza. Well, this is only just a stanza. And then, Tanaga follows a particular form rhyme patterns, while Dayona don't follow a pattern. I hope that is clear. Now, let's proceed. Haiku. Yan. A haiku poem has three lines, where the first and last line have five moras, ibig sabihin, syllables. And the middle line has seven. So the first and the third line, okay? We have the first and the third line having five syllables each, while the second line has seven syllables each. So definitely there are how many syllables in a haiku? There are 17 syllables. The mora is another term for sound unit or syllable, okay? The lines of such poems rarely rhyme with each other. It may rhyme, it may also not rhyme. Now, bear in mind that if you're going to make a haiku, the specific themes of how haiku were made are actually the four seasons: winter, spring, summer, and fall. More likely, as you know it, haiku originated from Japan. And you know Japan as a country. They love arts, no? That's why Japanese haiku poets, when they make haikus, it is definitely inspired by nature, inspired by the four seasons, the winter, spring, summer, and fall. But sir, can we make haiku that doesn't actually talk about nature or any of the four seasons? Yes, you may. I was just trying to say that most haikus were made from the theme of nature or environment and the four seasons. Okay? Here is an example of a haiku. Red, blue, they differ. Bees come, go, butterflies too. Beautiful flowers. Technically, we can say that the theme of this particular haiku is talking about the environment. More so with spring. Yung pagsibol, kumbaga, ng mga flowers and different types of plants in the environment. Okay? Now, if you are going to talk about the number of syllables per line, the first line has five, the second line has seven, and the third line has also five as well. Now, take note. Haiku poems frequently have a kigo or seasonal reference and should have meaning. As I told you, haikus were perfectly made when it comes to environment and the four seasons. But when you make a haiku, it doesn't mean like you're just going to throw words to the line so that you can make the 575 syllabic number pattern. No, your haikus should have a meaning, should be understood. I hope that is clear. I hope that is very, very clear. All right? So that's just the short discussion that we are going to have. Now, for your practice or for your activity, I have put there in your LMS the things that you have to do. Of course, you must miss making poems, right? So yes, you are going to make a Tanaga, a Dayona, and a haiku. Alright? For both... English na lang, para isa lang ka language yung buhatan. So you are going to make all those three, and please make it as you are time. No, I will be fixing the time. As to when will be the cutoff for the submission, and you really need to at least submit those on time. Okay? Now, class, bear this in mind, please. There's one more lesson that we need to talk about, but I will not be able to include it in our discussion through video because I really need to talk to you or discuss it to you personally, maybe next week after your examination. But there are at least three questions in your examination which were taken from the discussion that we have not discussed yet, which is the sonnet. All I have to do now, all you have to do is that I will be uploading a PPT about Sonnet to your LMS, and please just read it, okay? The questions that are in your examinations were just identification about sonnets, but it is definitely vital for you to read the PPT as well. All right? I hope you understand the three conventional forms of poetry, Tanaga, Dayona, and Haiku. And again, next week after your examination, we are going to discuss sonnet and the different types of sonnets. Thank you so much, class. Have a nice day ahead, and please proceed to writing your poems. God bless you all.